Hello, and welcome to Art Snacks. In this episode, we're going to talk about the role of the colonial brick maker. And it might not sound too exciting to be a brick maker, but when you consider how many things were made from brick at the time, they really were instrumental in making sure that things stood the test of time. And many, many of these buildings are still standing and still strong today because the brick maker knew his trade well. They were used in construction and repair throughout colonial America. Usually unskilled laborers made bricks, but it was hard work. They had brick firing traditions in some places like Williamsburg. For instance, October would be a time when they might fire a lot of bricks. We'll talk a little bit about that and the process. In the meantime, we're going to go ahead and draw a few things, but we're going to talk a little bit about the ways that you made bricks. So first, we're going to just draw a brick, and that's pretty easy because that'll be like a three-dimensional rectangle, sort of, okay? But they would take this native clay and put it into a treading pit, and they'd stick it all in the treading pit. We'll just draw a few things here. Let's draw a treading pit. So here's a pit that basically somebody went in there and they walked on it, basically, and it was a little lumpy inside the treading pit. And they would add water to it and add more water to it until the clay was ready, then plastic and easy to move around, malleable. And then they would offload that onto a molding table. Okay, so here's the treading pit. They would offload that onto a molding table where a molder would pat it into basic shapes. And these are not very square yet. They're sort of shaped sort of like a brick. Okay, they'd pat it into a basic brick shape. And then they would drop it into a mold. And that mold, let's just draw a mold, would be a piece of wood. Now, why did they use a mold? Okay, so this thing here is a mold, and it's made out of two pieces of wood that go across this way. So what do they put in the mold? The clay that they've formed up, right? And about brick size, they slam it into the mold, and then now the clay is inside this mold. Then once it's set in the mold, they take it over to a sand pit area and shake it out of the mold and leave it on the sand to dry for a while. And it dries there, for a while. And then they clean off the table and get ready for the next brick, okay? So they called it off-bearing. They bared it off of the table and onto the raised sand beds. Anyway, those would sit there for a while, but after a week or so, these almost or somewhat dry bricks are put in a drying shed. And so we'll draw a little shed over here. They're put in a drying shed. Piles and piles and piles and piles and piles of these bricks left there to dry for six more weeks, okay? And when they are finally done with this, they would be ready to stack them into these big stacks of bricks and start a big old fire, and they'd be sealed in with clay. Amount 20,000 bricks at a time, okay? About a finger's width apart to allow the fire to move in between and to draft upward through the bricks. This would burn. And the bricks would be heated, and because they're clay, they would turn hard. The fires would burn about 6 days, day and night, and they'd make sure that the fire didn't get bigger, and they would add more wood if they had to keep the fire nice and hot. The temperature inside that kiln would be 1,850 degrees Fahrenheit. And when they were done, they had a whole bunch of bricks, and that was the job of the brickmaker in colonial America. See you next time.